How's it going, everybody? It's your bro here. Hope you're doing well. And in this video, I'm going to be teaching you guys about threads in Java. So let's get into it. If you find this video helpful, please remember to like, comment, and subscribe. Your support will help keep this channel running. Hey everyone, so for this video, we're going to be discussing threads. This is going to be part one of two, where this video is going to be focusing on explaining what threads are, and part two will be multi-threading. So a thread is defined as a thread of execution in a program. I know that kind of sounds redundant. It's kind of like a virtual CPU, and the JVM, the Java Virtual Machine, allows an application to have multiple threads running concurrently. So each thread can execute parts of your code in parallel with the main thread, and each thread has its own priority. Threads with higher priority are executed in preference compared to threads with a lower priority. So with the Java Virtual Machine, it will continue to execute threads until either one of the following occurs. The exit method of class runtime has been called, or all user threads have died. Then the program stops, basically. So when the JVM starts up, there is a thread which calls the main method, this right here. And this thread is called main. So it's kind of like the thread that starts or begins your program. So let's do some practice with the main thread. So with threads, we can check to see how many are active with a certain method. So we're going to type in the name of the thread class, dot, and use the active count method. And this returns how many threads are currently active. However, we need to put this within a print line statement so we can actually see it. So I'm just going to system.out.println and place thread.activeCount within here. And let's see how many threads are running. And it says one thread is currently running, and that is our main thread, basically. And we can also check to see the name of this specific thread. So we can use thread.currentThread.get name. So this is going to return the name of the main thread, basically. And then we'll also need to put this within a print line statement. So let's just copy this and paste it within here. And I'll probably just turn this into a comment for now. All right, so the name of the thread that is currently running is named main, just like we had in that description just previously. We can also change the name of this thread too. So we can use the set name method of the thread class. So we're going to type in thread, and then we want the current thread, which is main. So thread.currentThread, and then what we're going to type is .setName. And we can name this whatever we want. So how about main for no good reason? So when we display the name of the current thread, it's going to be main with a bunch of n's. It's probably not a practical name, I was just being silly. So all threads have a priority, and we can check to see what a thread's priority is. So if we want to check the priority of our main thread, what we're going to type is thread.currentThread, which is referring to the main thread, dot get priority. And then of course we need to put this within a print line statement. So system.out.println. Then I'm just going to place this within here. And the priority of our main thread is 5. So this is on a scale between 1 and 10. The higher the number, the higher priority for this thread. So we can actually change the priority for a thread. So let's change the priority for our main thread. So I'm just going to type in thread.currentThread, which is referring to the main thread. And we're going to use the .setPriority method. So this is on a scale between 1 and 10. 10 being the highest priority, and 1 being the lowest. So if we changed this thread's priority to 10, and then we get the priority, it's going to display 10. So this main thread now has the highest priority, and if we changed it to 1, it now will have the lowest priority possible then. And one other useful method with threads is that we can check to see if a thread is currently alive. So what we can do is use the isAlive method. So if we want to check to see if our main thread is alive, we're going to type in thread.currentThread.isAlive, and then put this within a println statement. So system.out.println, and then we are going to type in thread current thread is alive, and it's going to check to see if our main thread is alive, and it says it is true. Alright, so one other thing that you can do with threads is that you can have a thread sleep, so it's kind of like your program is paused. So why don't we make some sort of counter, and this will count down by seconds. So what I'm going to do is create a for loop, and we'll say int I, and we'll start at 3. We'll count down from 3. And then we'll continue this for loop as long as I is greater than 0. And then let's decrement I by 1 each time. And then what we're going to do within this for loop is just display whatever I is. And then we're going to type in thread.sleep. And then we can type in how many milliseconds we want this thread to sleep after each iteration of this for loop. So let's have this pause for 1 second, so it's kind of like we're counting down. Now you'll notice that this is underlined red. It says unhandled exception type interrupted exception, so you can surround this with a try and catch block, or add throws declaration at the top here, and that error should go away. And then once we exit this loop, we'll just display a message such as, you are done. Okay, let's try this. So normally when we have a for loop like this, it iterates through these almost instantaneously. But now if we had thread.sleep for 1 second, it's kind of like we're counting down by 1 second at a time then in 1 second intervals. So that's how you can use the thread.sleep method to have your thread or program sleep for a given amount of time. So now what we're going to do is actually create a second thread along with our main thread, and there's one of two ways that we can create another thread. I'll show you guys one way in this video, and in the next video on multi-threading, I'll show you guys another way. So one way is that we can create a child class of the thread class. So let's go to our project folder, go to File, New, Class, and let's call this My Thread. And this My Thread class will extend the thread class. So my thread is going to inherit everything from the thread class. There's actually this method called run within the thread class, and we're going to override that so my thread will do something else. So it's going to be a public method that is void, and it's called run. And since we're overriding this, we should probably add a note for good practice that says override, because we're overriding this method. So when run is executed, let's just display that this thread is running. Okay, so this is everything we need to do within our MyThread class. So let's create an instance of MyThread. So it's kind of like we're creating an object, basically. So we're going to type in the name of the class, MyThread, and let's call this thread2 equals new MyThread. And this will create a second thread along with our main thread that is currently running. Now with the second thread, we can use some of these methods that we used for the first thread. So let's check to see if this thread is currently alive. So what we're going to type is the name of our thread. So thread2.isAlive. And we're going to put this within a println statement. So system.out.println. We're going to check to see if thread2 is alive. And this returns false. And this is the reason why. When you start a new thread or create a new thread, you need to start it so that it begins, basically. So we're going to type in thread2.start. And this will start our thread. So this will display that this thread is currently alive. And also notice that it executed our run function, which just displays this thread is running. So it can be tempting to put run here in place of start. But if you were to check to see its status here, it's going to say that this thread is currently not alive, but it does execute our run function. So if you want this thread to start, you'll want to be sure to use the start function and not just the run function. So that's how you can check to see if a thread is currently alive. Let's go over a few others. Let's check to see what this thread's name is. So we're going to type in the name of our thread. So thread2 dot get name, and then put this within a println statement. So system.out.println thread2 get name. And the name of this thread is thread-0. And remember, with our main thread, that was just named main. So we can also change the name of this thread. So I'm just going to copy this. And before the print line statement, we'll just type in thread2.setName. And let's change this to maybe second thread or whatever you want. So if we were to display the name of our second thread, thread two, it's now named second thread. Now let's check thread two's priority. So we'll type the name of this thread, thread2.getPriority, and then place this within a println statement again, system.out.println, thread2.getPriority. And this has a priority of 5, which is the default basically. Now, if you have one thread that creates another thread, it's going to inherit the priority of the thread that created it. So if we went back to our main thread and we set the priority to, let's say, 10, the highest priority. So this priority of thread 2 is now going to be 10, since it inherits the priority of the thread that created it, which in this case would be main. So we can also set the priority like we did here. So that is the set priority method. So we're going to type in thread2.setPriority, and let's set this to 1. So thread 2 now has a priority of 1. Then compared to our main thread, this by default has a priority of 5. So the main thread has a higher priority than our thread 2 thread, basically. So one other thing we can do is that we can check to see how many threads are currently active, kind of like what we did with our first example. So we're going to use the thread.activeCount, and I'm going to copy this and paste it, and it's going to display how many threads are currently active. And it says 1. That's because we need to start thread 2. And now the amount of threads that are currently active is 2, because we needed to start thread 2. Now, we have one last thing to discuss. There's two different kinds of threads. They are user threads and daemon threads. That sounds kind of cool, right? So a daemon thread is a low priority thread that runs in the background to perform tasks such as garbage collection, and the Java virtual machine terminates itself when all user threads, which are non-daemon threads, finish their execution. So if we were to create another thread, this would normally by default be a user thread, a non-daemon thread, but we can actually change it so it is a daemon thread. First, let's check to see if it is a daemon thread. So there's actually a method for this. We type the name of the thread, so thread2 dot, and we'll use the isDaemon method, and then we need to put this within a println statement. So system.out.println, thread2.isDaemon. And then we'll display this and run it. So it says false. So this thread is not a daemon thread, but we can actually set it so it is. So we're going to type in thread2.setDaemonTrue and run this again. And it says true. So this is a daemon thread and it runs the program. Now we can actually change the MyThread class, and we can check to see if this is a daemon thread. So if this dot is daemon, we'll display this is a daemon thread that is running. Otherwise else, we'll just display system.out.println, this is a user thread that is running. All right, so if we were to revert this back to false, it displays this is a user thread that is running, and if we change this to a daemon thread, it's going to display this is a daemon thread that is running. So like we said with daemon threads, they are low priority threads that run in the background to perform tasks such as garbage collection, and the Java virtual machine will terminate when all user threads, which are non-daemon threads, finish their execution. So it's kind of like the Java virtual machine doesn't care if there's daemon threads running in the background. It'll exit regardless, as long as all user threads finish their execution. So it's kind of like daemon threads are low priority, kind of like what we did with setting the priority for threads. So that's the basics of Threads. It's kind of like a virtual CPU that has its own like set of instructions, and we can have multiple threads running concurrently at the same time. And another definition for this is multi-threading, and that's something we'll cover in the next lesson. So that's the basics of Threads. If you want a copy of all this code, I'll post all of this in the comments down below. But yeah, that's the basics of Threads in Java. Hey you. Yeah, I'm talking to you. If you learn something new, then you can help me help you in 3 easy steps by smashing that like button, drop a comment down below, and subscribe if you'd like to become a fellow bro.